Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your wages are being garnished. We can stop that now. It's hard enough to pay your bills when things are good, let alone when a big chunk of your take-home pay is gone before you even get your check. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagné, and I can stop the garnishment and get the creditors off your back immediately, often the same day as our consultation. Both Chapter 7 and 13 provide bankruptcy relief, but choosing the right chapter is crucial. In a free consultation, we can create a plan to get your finances back under your control. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. We get our loud and local band of the week. This week, it's the Sky Giants. Sky Giants. You want to find out more info, where their music is, where their music is playing?
They've put out a 7-song demo called What the Future Knows. It actually came out last year, but they're putting out a full length, my bad, and it's called The Shifting of Phase World. So you can get The Shifting of Phase World now. Ooh. And if you want to see them, I don't know, maybe you're going to Wenatchee tonight. And if you are, swing on by Wally's Tavern, because they're going to be there. If you want to see them in the Northwest, like in Tacoma or Seattle, Tacoma, they're at the Valley on March 22nd.
Yeah, and don't forget, if you love local music, you're going to love Sunday nights here on The Rock. Every Sunday night at 10 o'clock, two solid hours of Pacific Northwest music. Great bands like the Sky Giants.
We made it.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
We got through.
We
made it through snowpocalypse. Well, most of us. Some people are still buried. Sorry, North Bend.
North Bend is still North Bend.
Yeah, they got feet of it. It's insane.
They got feet of it. Yes, they do.
Language is so easy for you. For all of us, really.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get to our contestant today. We got Danny in Puyallup. Danny, are you there, sir?
Yeah.
What's he playing for today?
It's a Puyallup greeting.
Oh.
You guys made fun of me, but clearly Danny proved the point.
That's
how they do it.
That's how we talk in Puyallup.
That's how you do the Puyallup. What's he playing for today, Steve?
Well, he's playing for tickets to check out Shinedown. They're going to be at the Showwear Center on July 26th. You can go to KISW.com for all the details. If you want tickets, they are available now at ShowwearCenter.com.
All right, Steve, get out of here. For those playing at home, Danny will have 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. Danny, you can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yep.
Not you.
Let's do it.
This Danny, yes. Which astronomer gave his name to a telescope launched into space into 1990?
Hubble.
Yes. Love Me Tender was the first movie which famous musician starred in?
Prince.
No.
Oh. Pass.
Sri Lanka is surrounded by which ocean?
The Atlantic.
No.
Pacific.
No.
Arctic.
No. Oh. In 2003, which famous actor became governor of California?
Yeah.
Schwarzenegger.
Yes. Pluto was demoted to a dwarf planet in what year of the mid-2000s?
2006.
Yes. How many eggs would you have if you had two baker's dozens?
26.
Yes. Woo! What did John Hancock sign in 1776?
Declaration of Independence.
Yes. John McEnroe was a professional at what sport?
Football.
No.
Golf.
No.
Tennis.
Yes. How many faces appear on Mount Rushmore?
Four.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Correct.
All right, we'll see, man.
It'll be close.
We'll see.
Well, maybe you'll get your loser song.
I hope so.
Maybe Steve will get his winner song. Maybe we won't get any song.
Oh, wow, look at you.
Anything could happen. Well, no. Only those three things can happen.
Anything can happen.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it used to be anything can happen Friday. Can we bring it back?
No.
Oh,
no.
Crap. Fine. Steve.
Yeah. Yeah.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Which astronomer gave his name to a telescope launched into space in 1990?
Sputnik.
No.
Good old Sputnik. Oh, man. Miss Cleo.
No.
That's it. Ah, son of a... Edison.
No. Love Me Tender was the first movie which famous musician starred in. Yes.
Well, remote.
Sri Lanka is surrounded by which ocean?
Oh, the Indian Ocean.
Yes.
Nice.
In 2003, which famous actor became governor of California?
Yeah. Arnold. Yeah. Schwarzenegger.
Pluto was demoted to a dwarf planet in what year? The mid-2000s.
2004.
No.
2005.
No.
2006.
Yes. Nice. How many eggs would you have if you had two baker's dozen?
26.
Yes. What did John Hancock sign in 1776?
Oh, he signed a lease to a new car.
No.
Declaration of Independence.
Yes. John McEnroe was a professional at what sport?
Tennis.
Yes. How many faces appear on Mount Rushmore?
Four.
Yes. Lake of the Ozarks is located in which U.S. state?
That would be Arizona.
No.
Nevada.
No.
Minnesota.
No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You win.
Yes.
8-7. Yeah.
Did you get that last question from Ozark?
No, but it does work.
Yeah.
Because I have seen both seasons.
All right. There you go.
Nice. Sorry about that, Danny.
Yeah. You lost, Danny.
Steve won.
That's right.
Whatever. Whatever.
Yeah.
Yaha.
Yaha.
I can't play the music, guys.
Oh.
Just keep going.
Oh, okay.
My box is frozen.
Oh, I was just waiting for you.
I can't do anything.
You're the best.
Well, in that case, if you can't play
No loser song. No.
Come on.
There we go.
There we go.
Thank you, Danny. Danny brought a band in.
Okay. He just got one in his pocket. It's amazing.
Yeah, buddy. Damn it. I was so close. Gotta play some kind of song.
So, BJ, where is the Lake of the Ozarks located?
I don't know because I haven't watched enough of the show. but I know that they're on that. I know that's where they go.
Missouri.
Oh, I should have said it.
Yeah.
I suck.
And then one of the ones that Danny did get correct that you did not, Steve, the astronomer, not astrologer, that gave his name to a telescope launched into space in 1990 was Hubble, Mr. Edwin Hubble.
I heard that before.
You heard about the Hubble telescope, haven't you?
I have.
Yeah, you have.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's not a Miss Cleo telescope.
No, there isn't.
Or a Sputnik telescope.
Yeah, if it was a horoscope that they launched into space,
right?
Yeah, it would have been Miss Cleo, probably.
Congratulations, though, Steve. You won with 8 correct.
Caller number 8. You are checking out Shinedown at the Showwear Center in July. Caller number 8, 206-421-ROCK. That is caller number 8, just like that. Got a new study. Found out this. And Steve, I wonder where your parents weigh in on this one.
Okay.
Because I know your parents are keepsake hoarders.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. So it says that parents, the average parent, will hold on to almost 1,300 keepsakes from their kids' childhood, and 75% of them are photos.
Oh man. We're including photos?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Dude, that would be an understatement.
Yeah.
Triple that. With the photos alone. Because, yeah. I mean, when we went and visited my parents on Thanksgiving, we went through so many. I mean, I'm sending you guys pictures of all these pictures I found in these photo. Some of them are not even photo albums. They're just in still those envelopes. But
yeah.
It's a ridiculous amount of photos. But I thought when my parents moved from Brooklyn to New Jersey, we told them, my brother and I told them, just get rid of everything.
Yeah.
Anything that has, like, look, there might be a couple things I wish I would have kept, and I won't tell them because I don't want to even risk that they didn't keep them and they would have a meltdown.
Yeah.
But when we went, my mom was trying to push off this old Sesame Street figurine house to my wife. You should take it back with you. You know, you guys, if you ever have kids, this is great. I'm like, Mom, why did you keep this?
Nobody wants that.
She's like, I kept it so you could give it to the kids. I'm like, why did my brother and his kids have it? They didn't want it. I'm like, there's a reason.
There you go. They didn't want it. That means I don't want it.
But I hit a point where I'm like, I could give my mom a hard time about being a hoarder. Or, you know what? It makes her happy knowing that she still has them. But
yeah,
it's ridiculous how many keepsakes she still has.
And you're right, dude, with the photos, because we're not talking digital photos. The digital photos, man, that has to be, geez, into the thousands at that point. But just regular, you know, hard copy photos.
They don't have anything digital. Dude, if they see a picture on my Facebook that they like, my dad prints it.
Really?
And they keep it that way.
That is cool.
But he prints it on, like, just regular paper, so it's a really poor quality picture.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
All right, fine.
Yeah. Multiple shoe boxes filled with nearly 1,000 photos tucked away somewhere. Sounds like your parents are average. Yeah.
That's my parents, too.
Yeah. About half the parents in the survey said they wish they'd saved even more stuff. We really are bad parents. I don't think I got a lot.
The weirdest keepsake that my parents kept. I'm curious if you guys even know what yours would be. But for my mom, I remember the first time my wife met my mom, came over, she was my girlfriend at the time. She's showing it all these different, you know, keepsakes. And then she pulls out a penthouse and is like, remember this one, Steven? And I'm like, what? I'm like, what are you doing, Mom?
That
remember
is
this
nuts.
One? And here's the reason. There wasn't any sexy girl on the cover. It was Howard Stern.
Ah.
The penthouse that he was on the cover, so I needed it because I was such a big Howard Stern fan growing up.
Oh.
But it's still weird that your mom is pulling out a penthouse, even if it's Howard Stern on the cover. It doesn't matter if it's the Mother Teresa's on the cover. That'd be weirder.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
But you know what I mean?
Your mom is a wild child.
And my wife's looking at me like, what is your mom? Like, hey, it's weird you had a penthouse.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not that weird.
I know, but, you know, some people view it as weird. And then really weird that your mom is showing it off as a keepsake.
It is such a culture clash. Anyway, because Northeasterners are just, you know, whatever. What's the big deal? It was Howard Stern. Who cares? And plus, you're an adult now. But, you know.
Steven, remember this?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, man.
I remember it more than you'd like for me to remember.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Oh, my parents, especially my mom, are the biggest hoarders. I think in the garage, I still have my stroller. Uh-huh. I still have my little bouncy thing. You put the babies into bounce. We have so much crap.
You gotta get rid of that
stuff. Anything weird?
The weirdest thing is when I was born, my mom took, like, little nail clipping trimmings
from
I was born. She put it in my baby book.
Yep.
Oh. She put it, like, for my first haircut, put a little piece of hair. You know, she's got my band-aids from when they gave me shots. And
band-aids?
Yeah.
Wow. See, the hair I don't mind, but the fingernail clippings not
band-aids.
Oh,
she did fingernail and toes. And then you know how they have that weird little gross button on their belly button?
Yeah.
That little black thing? That's taped into my album. Still. Almost 30 years later.
I don't want that.
Yep, it's still there.
Mine was one time I was looking through my mom's room for something, and I was looking for like my class ring or something, and I dumped out her jewelry, and all of a sudden all these teeth fall out.
Oh,
and I was like, what is this?
We still have my teeth,
and
too.
And she's like, oh, yeah, that was the tooth fairy, and I was like, makes sense.
Yeah.
Like, what do you do with the teeth afterwards? A lot of people just keep them.
Yeah.
Make a necklace.
Oh, one time.
Some people do.
My dad's in his 60s. When his parents passed, he found all of his old report cards from like sixth grade.
Yeah, that's what a lot of people save.
Report cards?
They save a lot of report cards in this, yeah.
That's something that nowadays no one's ever going to experience, because I doubt you go home with a report card. You probably just get an email.
Yeah. You're right. That's a good point. And toys, of course, you know, they save some of your toys.
A lot of my
parents
toys.
Parents are saving that. Art projects from school. I have a couple of art projects that I've saved. But I save all the greeting cards that I get in my entire life, including the ones the kids made for me. So I have some stuff. Also, Christmas decorations. I think it's the perfect time of year to save all the kids' stuff, because then, you know, every year you get to bring them out and see. But then they get stored in the Christmas boxes.
My mom keeps trying to pawn off one of my Christmas ornaments, and my wife's like, no, we don't need it.
Oh, you got to take it.
Bro, I made a Barney Rubble Christmas ornament.
Nice.
Not even Fred Flintstone.
Yeah.
I was really obsessed with Barney Rubble as a kid.
Yeah, Fred was kind of a jerk.
And Barney was a cool dude.
He was real nice.
Until his voice changed. I didn't like him when he changed his voice.
I know, I hated that.
It was really weird.
Yeah, it was totally like, okay. Thanks.
It was insulting.
Yeah, it was.
This is not my Barney Rubble.
And I find that interesting. You guys didn't take that home because it's adorable to have something like a little keepsake from when you were a kid, like a Christmas decoration.
Probably should.
Yeah, because I have some of the ugly stuff that the kids made. Mm-hmm. And they're a beating. But you know what? We kept them because, look at this. Is a little snowman that Joey made that looks like it just was in a car accident. But we're going to keep this anyway. Yeah.
So this is my 45-year-old foreskin. It's in my baby book that my grandma made.
Whoa. No, grandma.
That's worse than the belly button.
Bad grandma.
Bad grandma.
Yeah. Damn. Clothing? I don't know if I would keep clothing. I give that away.
Yeah.
My mom has a lot of like the special stuff, the things that we would wear constantly would not change out of. Like she's got my brother's Barney pajamas. She has a couple of my dresses.
That's too much. Yeah, you got to get rid of that stuff.
Why?
Because it's just hoarding. I mean, it's just like...
She's saving it for her grandkids.
No one's going to wear that. No one will wear that. If you
actually, some of the cute little dresses I would.
Yeah, really?
They're so cute.
Oh, God. All right.
She says, I'm stoked my mom kept all my Matchbox and Hot Wheels cars and my Legos. Legos. That's like saving gold.
Yeah, exactly. See, that's the thing. The stuff you want them to save, they didn't save. If my dad didn't throw out all my comic books and actually just save them...
Mm-hmm.
He would have been dad of the year.
Yeah.
And he threw them all out. I was like, these stupid things. What are these going to be?
You could have a padded bank account if you still had all of those.
You aren't kidding, man.
We still have all the Disney VHSs from growing up. So the Aladdins, the Hercules,
Beauty and the Beast. Those are collector's items.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not bad. Rev's right. And a lot of people do save those videos. Home movies. Well, that makes sense. Who doesn't save home movies?
Yeah.
Unless you transfer them to something else, why wouldn't you keep them?
I'd digitize them if I was someone. I just had a fear... We never had a video camera, though, growing up. We were never one of those families that had video cameras.
I didn't either, yeah.
So all we have is pictures, and an abundance of them, don't get me wrong. But if we had videos, I would love to have digitized them. They would be on YouTube right now.
I have one. I can't get it. I have an old reel-to-reel video from me doing a newscast in college with a giant afro.
Where is that?
I have it, but nobody can put it on to like a regular thing because it's a reel-to-reel video, and nobody has a reel-to-reel recorder anywhere.
Yeah.
That's the problem. If it was VHS or something, yeah. This is back in the late 70s where they made video, but it was on the big reel-to-reel tape.
We can recreate it. Just throw out your hair.
Dude, it's so awesome. I mean, I can't believe it. A giant afro that I had, I think, at the time. And it was kind of like, it was coming out like it was, you know. So, like, part of my hair is really straight at the roots. And then all of a sudden it just puffs out like a mushroom. Like, it's like an upside down mushroom.
Oh, man.
I know. I've taken it so many different places. I said, can anybody put this on anything so that I can watch this?
Not a single place.
Nobody had a reel-to-reel video, which is really surprising to me. Someone must have. If someone has one... So email us or Facebook us, and I would love to get this transferred.
Please, that would be the greatest thing ever that we could post on our social media.
I agree, dude, because it's 1978, and it's so 70s.
Oh my God, that was a year before I was born.
Oh yeah, dude, it's classic. Me in college doing a news report for my college, some sort of college class. Oh yeah. All right. Got 1 in 10 people that have done something rather ridiculous. Why? Because they just wanted to avoid paying the bill at a restaurant. And you know what? You might even be guilty of doing this, too. I'll tell you what it is. It's 717 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. According to a new survey, 1 in 10 people say that they have skipped out on a date early just to avoid paying the bill. That's pretty good.
So they leave the other person with the bill?
Yeah, they do.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
I'm glad that's never happened to me, but in a weird way, it would be kind of fun to have that happen so you have that story. Someone just bailing on you, leaving you with the check.
Survey also found that 15% of people have rejected a second date because the person didn't pay or even offer to pay on the first date. That's interesting.
You always got to pull the, even if you don't expect to pay, you pull the wallet or the purse out and kind of hoping, you know, hey.
Well, you're from a generation where that it's possible that, you know, a woman could pay for it. You know, I don't know what it. I don't know. You know, I don't know what it is actually in the gay community. I don't know who's considered the one that should pay because in the heterosexual community in my generation, it was always the male. The male always had to pay no matter what.
I would. I mean, I would imagine whoever asks a person out on the date there's almost this, not expectation, but it's kind of implied that that's the person that's paying for the date. And I don't think that would translate to no matter what your sexuality
makes
is.
Makes sense to me.
In my head, that seems to make sense.
That fits everybody.
If I ask someone out on a date or to go out, sometimes even just like buddies, like if I'm the one that's like, hey, let's go get lunch, and we do, I'm thinking, I'll probably spring for the lunch as long as it's not anywhere fancy.
Right. Like I've invited guys. I'm like, hey, would you like to go get drinks? And then they're surprised when I'm paying for the drinks.
That's
like,
actually really cool.
I'm like, well, I invited you. If you really want, you can pay for the next ones.
Right. Get me next time.
Yeah.
Now I know why you guys never invite me anywhere. No, you guys don't want to pay. I can see why. All right. Exactly. Now I get it.
See? You're on to us, BJ.
I knew it.
I've said, hey, come to Karma. If you ever come to Puyallup, we'll go to Karma.
Oh, yeah. You have said that.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't realize there was the inference that maybe you'd be paying.
Just wait till like next Friday for payday.
Okay.
Low on funds after Valentine's Day. Just kidding.
Fair enough.
Now it's the lukewarm topic of the day.
So 1 in 10 people say, yeah, they have left a date early to avoid paying the bill. So we're asking you, have you ever left a date early? And what was the reason? Or maybe a date left you early. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Have you ever left a date early? Why? Or has a date ever left early on you? We'll take your calls and texts after Pearl Jam on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. 1 in 10 people have left a date early to avoid paying the bill. What about you? Have you ever left a date early? And why was that? Or maybe a date has left early on you. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Let's go to George in Tacoma. George, you are on The Rock.
Hey, BJ, what's up?
Hey, George, not too bad, buddy. What you got going on for you?
So this is probably about a year ago now. I downloaded a dating app just to try it out. And I hit it off with this chick, and it seemed really cool. We had similar interests and same age, so we figured why not meet up. Her height said 4'11 on her profile, and I did not believe her. And I'm almost like probably 5'10, 5'11. And when we met in person, it was at Dave & Buster's, and I was blown away. This person was half my size, and it was like I was hanging out with a 10-year-old. So, like, the entire time I'm trying to, like, cut this thing short and just move on, and I felt so bad. Because I feel like I'm a pretty nice person. But after we said our goodbyes and stuff, she, like, tried to kiss me, and I just couldn't do it, and it just really pissed her off. And then I kind of ghosted her.
So you knew she was 4'11", but you didn't believe it?
No, because people lie all the time on dating apps.
Did you think? Yeah, I would never really. I think more dudes would probably lie about their height than chicks, in my opinion.
Yeah, I don't know why she would say she was 4'11 if she wasn't. I don't know what her goal would be for that.
When she went in to kiss you, since she was 4'11, did you stand up real tall and kind of pull the old like trying jump up to my lips kind of thing? If you can reach my lips, you can kiss me.
No, I didn't have to do that, but I felt so bad. I mean, I've never done that to a person, but...
So let me ask you, George.
Height would never be a deal-breaker.
Yeah, because let me ask you, was she attractive? Like, would you, if she was closer to your height, would you have been, like, into this chick?
Honestly, probably not.
There we go.
Okay.
See, because I got
that
news.
Was just one of many reasons.
I think Anna Kendrick was in studio, and I think she's 4'11". Isn't she, Steve? She's shorter than Vicky.
She was very small.
Yeah.
Her head was bigger than the rest of her body. It was
weird. Yeah, she was.
She's 5'2". She's about my height.
She's 5'2"?
Wow.
Okay, so this girl's even shorter than Anna Kendrick. Well, I can see your point, dude. 4'11 is even shorter. I thought Anna Kendrick was 4'11".
She's tiny.
Yeah, and she's very, very tiny. But Anna Kendrick's a pretty woman, and so, I mean, as tall as I am, I'd be like, all right Anna, let's have a conversation.
What about girls that are taller? Some guys have issues dating someone. That's never been my issue. Obviously, being 6'3", it's very rare that you...
Yeah.
But I've never even like dated a person that's over like 5'6". Yeah. But sometimes you hear these stories of dudes that just will not date a woman if she is taller than him.
I would be super like intimidated if a girl was like taller than me. Especially like even like my ex-wife, she... wasn't taller than me until she wore any kind of heel or even like a platform. Mm-hmm. And so when we'd go to weddings, I just felt really awkward.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't like it.
See, and you feel bad for sometimes the taller ladies because you could tell they're trying not to look tall. They'll wear like those flat shoes, even at formal things. And I'm a fan of chicks in heels. Like, I'd rather you be 7 feet tall, but be able to show those sweet stems with the heels on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've pissed off a lot of tall girls because I've dated really tall guys.
Oh, yeah. Remember that one guy that I had to look up to?
6'8".
Yeah, whoa. That was hysterical.
Oh, my gosh.
He was like two times the size
yes.
of you. You guys crack me up. You look like, I'm just like, I don't know how this is going to get done.
Yeah.
You look like a guy wearing with those stilts on. Like, yeah. You see, like, something like,
yeah, he did.
And like those haunted forests. And oddly enough, we were at a haunted forest when we saw Vicky with him.
Yeah, that was hysterical.
Yeah, so I try to date a little shorter just for the tall girls. I got you, ladies.
It doesn't bother me. As a matter of fact, here in Washington State, everyone's much taller than me. They grow big out here.
One person says I'm 5'11", my last two boyfriends. Were shorter than me.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah, and 5'11", you know, for a woman, 5'11 is tall. And then you throw some heels on and she's over 6 foot.
It's another person. I'm 6 foot. My girlfriend's 6'2".
Nice.
Yeah. I don't have a problem with it. I
mean, everyone's same height laying down, right, boys?
There's something sexy about a tall girl, though. She looks like an Amazonian woman, like just...
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah, but see, that's not a problem for you. If it's girl and girl, one's going to be taller than the other, and it's not a problem because that's going
to
happen.
I'm trying to support this way of thinking, man.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you like everything.
I don't like you.
That's a good point.
Or oysters, as we learned.
Or oysters.
Say, I'm in a good crowd. Yep. She doesn't like me or oysters. All right. Let's go to Ben in Linwood, 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Ben, you are on the Rock.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Not too bad, Ben. How about you? Have you ever left a date early, or did somebody leave a date early on you?
So, I've never left a date early because I'm a guy, and they just don't come that often, and so I'm taking it for what I can. But when I was in college, I was at a party, and me and this girl that were in choir together, we've been talking back and forth for a while, and I'd just gotten out of a long-term serious relationship, so she was going to be my rebound, and, you know, we kind of planned it. And so we went to this party together. I was all massaging her shoulders, and we were having a good time. We were drinking. And then she disappeared to go upstairs and have a threesome with another guy and his girlfriend.
It's awful tough that's a tough offer to refuse. And how do you, there's nothing you can do to make a better deal than that unless you go find four people to be involved.
Or ask to be involved.
Well, I proceeded to get really drunk and go up there and crash the threesome, and it turned into just third base for him. So I was happy about it.
Oh, so you just C-blocked all of it.
Oh, yeah. No, completely.
See, Vicky's smart, because I think if Vicky was there, she would have invited you in, because there's no way she's going to want you to stop the action.
And that's why I love Vicky. She's my Valentine.
Aww. That must have been the most awkward moment for them. All of a sudden, here comes drunk Ben barging in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Especially since I pretended to be asleep on the floor to trick my friend into letting me run upstairs and do it.
That's exactly how James Bond would have done it, too.
Good job, Ben.
Nice work, Ben.
Yeah. Yeah, you see,
you warmed her up and she left you.
There's no way anyone's going to be happy that wants to have sex. You go, nah, you know what? I'm not going to have sex with you, but I'm going to go up there and have sex with them. It's like, no, that's not going to work. I've been working this all night. Really? You're in the mood, but not with me after I've been working?
Yeah, I would think to be more tactful and just act like as if you're leaving and then sneak upstairs.
Yeah.
That way you don't give him any idea that you're up there.
Don't give James Bond any info.
No, because you never know what Ben will do.
Yeah, you just don't want to do that.
I see your son's in the room.
Oh, great. This is fantastic.
Oh, man. Yeah, I wish I could say this was me, but this is one of my good friends. It's the greatest dating first date story I've ever heard. So he gets set up on a blind date, and he's trying to figure out where to take this chick. And he has a buy one, get one free coupon to Red Lobster. So he takes her to Red Lobster, right? And the chick's totally into it.
I hope he got the ultimate feast.
She did. Nice. She got that huge seafood platter, right?
Shrimp scampi, breaded shrimp,
lobster tail,
crab legs.
Yep,
all the good stuff.
Everything great, right? Cheddar biscuits, obviously included.
Well, yeah, that comes with that territory.
So halfway through the meal, he looks down, right, and she's already finished the whole thing.
Oh yeah,
okay. And this is, my friend's a big dude, and so he gets it in his head that she's just there to eat as much food as possible and never see him again. So at the end of the meal, no, who would do that, right? He gets up and goes to the back and goes to the waiter and gives him the buy one get one free coupon and orders another meal to go and then leaves the other half of the check with her and just never sees her again.
Wow.
That's some good. That's some good covert operation right there. He pulled off a good mission there.
That's a problem solver.
Yeah, right. And
like,
then,
if you ever had an interview for a job and they say, "Show us what, give us an example of your problem solving skills," I think that should be what he tells them.
Exactly. Yeah. He got an extra meal and only had to pay half the bill.
And ladies, this is important because guys, we're thick. We don't pick up on the subtleties. So if in fact she was giving him indications that things are going to be good for him, you need to be very overt about it when you're ordering the entire seafood department of a place. You really got to be overt. Like, no, dude, this is going to be good for you. Just let me continue with this seafood feast.
And he was a bigger guy. So we're like, man, if she likes to eat and you like to eat, you're a perfect match.
Yes.
Right.
He screwed it up.
Yeah.
I mean, buffet city.
He did get a lot of free cheddar biscuits, though.
Oh, yeah. I wonder if he told the story to the guy and go, dude, I got somebody who's, I taken on a date and she's just eating everything. I'm getting wrecked tonight. But
yeah, I wonder what's going on in her head, though, when all of a sudden he never comes back and she just gets the bill.
And only half the bill.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's kind of weird, right?
At least he was cool about
that
it.
That big of a douche. He's a douche, but not a huge douche.
Yeah, he's leaving me with my half of the bill. And, you know, that's the thing. If she thought she was getting free stuff, because you know people like that. People who, you know, get the free drinks at the bar, who will go on the date, that have no romantic interest in you whatsoever. I hate when people do that. It's like, no. You know what? Just say no. You know, you're not going to, you know, obviously someone's buying you something because they're trying to, you know, you're at a bar. Or you're asked out on a date. What do you think they want?
Yep.
They want something.
We have a text twice. I had to use the family emergency excuse because the dude was not who his picks were.
Oh. So we have one example where she was exactly what she said she was, and he was like, no, I'm out. And then...
I never understand the whole, I'm going to put up a picture of me from 15 years ago on my dating profile and not expect the person to be a little surprised when I show up and I'm not the spitting image of what my dating profile picture is.
I don't get that either.
Right. Or guys, I hate it when guys complain like, oh, girls just put on way too much makeup on these and they really never wear makeup. Mm-hmm. I went on a date with a dude. He looked like this gorgeous Viking dude. He got the beard and the hair. It was hot. And I meet him and he's missing his teeth.
Whoa.
Oh, he didn't.
Was he not smiling in the picture?
It's all like that smirk, and I'm like, ooh. And I'm like, that's something. I mean, granted, he was kind of a boring dude, so that
be
was
careful
that's
when
why.
People don't smile. That's the trick of the trick. Yeah,
if they don't show teeth in their pictures when they're smiling,
they
if somebody
like them,
does the smirk smile, I always think their teeth are buckled.
Yeah,
and Vicky actually does that, even though your teeth are okay. You very rarely show your teeth.
Because always when I was a kid, I looked like an idiot. So
well, that hasn't changed.
No,
what's that got to do with your teeth?
I just look less of an idiot.
Yeah.
But I try to show them. I like my teeth.
Yeah, I know, but a lot of pictures you don't. Yeah. You're one of the people I go, wow, I bet people think Vicky's teeth are bad.
They're either bad or you look like a serial killer with that kind of a smile.
Why are you looking at me when you say
that? Because you know you tend to do that kind of smile.
Damn it!
I had really the only time I ever. Bailed on a date because, like Ben, I didn't get a whole lot of them.
Preach.
It was so bad because it was at a Hawks game, and I made it to halftime, but I had a huge thing of garlic fries because
oh boy,
yeah, I didn't realize that. When you ordered the chicken strips, you got garlic fries.
Yeah, uh-huh.
So I got more garlic fries.
Oh, boy.
And I ate almost all of them by myself.
Wait, you had two giant orders of garlic fries?
Yeah.
What a genius.
Yeah. And, of course, I didn't want them to go to waste.
No.
And the girl that I was with didn't actually have very many of them. Yeah, so halftime showed up, and I went to go take a siesta in the bathroom and realized it was going to be much, much worse, and I just I went home. I just texted her as I was walking to my car saying, I'm having stomach issues, I gotta go home. And that was literally,
And this was a date.
It was a date, yeah.
And what was her response?
Yeah. She didn't respond.
I don't blame her.
Pretty appropriate.
Yeah.
Wait, you did? I may have missed the story. I'm sorry if I did. But did you guys drive separately?
Okay. So, we met up there. It wasn't like a totally, absolutely bailed on her.
I was going to say, good luck finding a trip back.
Yeah, no, that would have been a lot worse. But, yeah, just because.
Ouch.
Yeah, you know, you, sir... need to prepare better because you know your own body. Two orders of garlic fries will not sit well with almost anybody, let alone you with your volatile gastrointestinal system.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and that was a learning moment.
Yeah, it was. Jeez, for all of us. Boy, and thank God you had your own vehicle to go home. And if you took public transportation, they would have never passed light rail. They would have people said, no, you don't understand. The rev might ride this. Damn.
There's only been one occasion where somebody left a date early, like that I was attending, and it was the dude. And he's like, oh, my God. found my brother stuck, like, down in Tacoma somewhere, you know, with his keys locked in his car or some kind of excuse like that. I gotta go. I'm so sorry. We had only had drinks at that point. I'm like, okay, cool. That's fine. And then I'm like, that doesn't, like, it felt weird.
Yeah.
So I did some digging.
Did you follow him?
No, I didn't follow
him. She did some digging. Oh, you are Sally Stalker.
On the internet. I'm like, this doesn't feel right. And my gut was right, because he had a fiance.
Oh.
Whoops.
I'm like, dude. And he tried messaging me again. I'm like, you're engaged. What the hell's wrong with you?
Wow.
She must have gotten off work early and was like, hey. Yep,
and I think that's what it was.
I'm heading home.
Oops.
Yep.
Yep. I better run. I better run. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I'm supposed to be home by now.
Yeah.
Cool. Damn, thanks for the D-picks.
So did you called him out on it?
I'm just like, yeah, no, I'm not hanging out with you again.
And what was his response?
I was like, yeah, I probably should get serious.
Whoa. Yeah. You might have been the catalyst for him to finally take this
engagement
serious. Yeah, they're married now.
Yeah.
But you have his D-picks, so who's the real winner?
I know. Yeah. It wasn't that impressive.
I was about to ask that. You answered my question.
He's pretty, but some parts aren't.
Who the hell sends D-picks if it's not impressive? You got to know what you're toting.
Well, you know, in all fairness, I mean, maybe he doesn't have a lot to base it off of. Not a lot of dudes are maybe like comparing it to other dudes' dongs, so he maybe thinks his is a phenomenal dong.
Jeez,
a phenomenon.
Yeah, all you have to do is watch phenomenon. One porn to realize.
I mean, he's
phenomenon. Phenomenon.
He might have thought it was good enough to get a fiance. Might be good enough to show off to other girls.
Yeah, you got to know where you stand in life.
You should have wrote her and said, "Hey, do you think this dong is as pretty as I think it is?"
Yeah,
because I don't think it's pretty at all.
Yeah, yeah, I. Yeah, I'm not sending mine anywhere because I've done research. Mine's, you know what? There's only one person that's going to see it. And of course, that's my priest. But anyway, hey,
right. Just a joke, people.
Dun-dun-dun.
Phenomenon.
You know that's going to be stuck in everybody's head this morning, Steve. Congratulations.
And afternoon.
Yeah.
Phenomenon.
Okay. We got to talk about this dude. You remember that guy that made news for fighting off a mountain lion that attacked him?
Yes.
Well, this guy spoke to the media for the first time since the attack, and yeah, as you can imagine, his story, amazing. You're going to hear from him at 7:47 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. How much does bankruptcy cost?
Usually with my office, we do a flat fee that includes all your court costs, filing fees, credit counseling, credit reports, and one cost. In Chapter 13 cases, that usually starts at about $900. With Chapter 7 cases, the total cost, including all your court costs, attorney fees, is usually about $1,500. We offer payment plans on Chapter 7, so you can start a file with my office for as little as $200. You can send your creditor calls to us. We'll take your creditor calls while you gather up your information and make payments on the rest of the fees. With Chapter 13 cases, we can make payment arrangements in most cases as well and get your case filed even sooner in a Chapter 13 case because of the reorganization aspect to it.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.